down there offensively.
I mean, they play some good defense. We just got a little stagnant. It was a different lineup out there for a little bit and just couldn't really manufacture anything, really. Obviously, we look at the film, but it was a couple turnovers at untimely, parts of the fourth quarter. A couple loose balls that bounced their way, and they capitalized off of them. With kind of some momentum changing threes, and that 3 minute stretch where it went from I think a 4 point game to 10 or 11 was a killer tonight. So at home you kind of want to hold on to the momentum as best you can, especially in the fourth quarter.
You guys went 6 of it. It's kind of been an extended slump for the whole team from three. How backbreaking are those plays where you get an open three? I mean, it's good offense and the guy just misses.
You obviously hope they go in, but that can't be a deciding factor whether that translates or spills over into a bad defensive possession. So I think for the most part, we offset that with some great defensive possessions and stops. Like I said, the difference tonight wasn't our shooting. It was offensive rebounds and a couple loose balls that went their way that they capitalized on in some key moments in the game that kind of decided it.
And that fourth quarter flurry of turnovers, is that their defense or a little bit of you guys too?
One dribble off my foot, that was tough. Can't really account for that. The other ones, they got a pass lane on one, which was kind of a bang-bang play. I got caught up in pick and roll one, and then I don't remember the rest, but, when the game's close and you're missing shots, those are, key possessions and pivotal possessions in a close game, and they capitalized on every single one of them. And, I don't know how many, they had 15 points off of turnovers. I'm pretty sure it's 7, 8, 9 of them right there in the fourth quarter, which is tough.
Steph, you mentioned that in the fourth quarter. Were you a little surprised to be out there in pretty much crunch time without Draymond and Klay in the game?
It's just kind of how the minutes fell tonight. And I don't really know exactly how long, they were on the bench. I can't really remember, but it was a different lineup, but you gotta still execute our game plan and still live up to our identity. We didn't do that.
Did it feel weird, MVP chance, for someone on your team? Obviously, that doesn't happen a lot at home.
Our fans are leaving. We didn't give me anything to cheer about, so you don't play into that much at all. The hype of opposing fans in the arena, we get them, and other teams' arenas too, can't be sensitive about that.
Steph, you guys have evolved to get the number one seed, but you've got San Antonio now. You guys are just a game and a half up on them. How do you reconcile wanting to go after it versus making sure you guys are fresh when you're playing so many games in the stretch in a bunch of cities?
I mean, we talk about it, but we need to focus on us in that perspective. It's not about looking behind us. We need to take care of our business, and tonight we didn't do that. And we do have a tough schedule, and it's part of the 82 that we all play every single year, and you got to be ready for it. Tough.
During the tail end of this really tough stretch of the schedule, Kurt has mentioned it a lot. Do you think some guys could use a game off here or two in the next couple games?
I know every guy in the locker room wants to play, so at the end of the day, that's our mentality. In the past, coaches obviously made some decisions that he thought were necessary at the time, and that's what coaches do. So we'll see if that happens. But as a player, like, every night is a chance to help your team win. And I mean, it sounds cliche, but literally, if you don't show up ready to play with that mentality, you're going to be behind the eight ball a little bit.
Great. Is that it? Thank you. Appreciate that. We'll have play open here in just a minute.